A woman mourns at an earthquake site in Sarpol Zahab in western Iran, Tuesday, November 14, 2017. Rescuers are digging through the debris of buildings felled by the Sunday earthquake in the border region of Iran and Iraq. Vahid Salimi, Associated Press. Sarpolezahab, Iran. Rescuers on Tuesday used backhoes and heavy equipment to dig through the debris of buildings toppled by a powerful earthquake on the border between Iran and Iraq, with weeping women crying out to God as aid workers found new bodies. The grim work began in earnest again at dawn in the Kurdish town of Sarpol Zahab in the western Iranian province of Kermanshah, which appears to be the hardest hit in the magnitude 7.3 earthquake. Kermanshah, an almost entirely Kurdish province nestled in the Zagros Mountains that run along the border with Iraq, suffered all of Iran's fatalities from the tremor Sunday night that shook 14 of the country's 31 provinces. Both rescuers and local residents alike stood atop the remains of apartment complexes Tuesday, looking through the rubble. They used heavy blankets to carry away corpses. The hospital in Sarpol Zahab was heavily damaged, and the army set up field hospitals, although many of the injured were moved to other cities, including Tehran. The quake also damaged an army garrison and buildings in the border city and killed an unspecified number of soldiers, according to reports. There are fears more dead could be in the rubble in Sarpol Zahab and other rural villages of Kermanshah province. Mohammad Ali Manchazadeh, a spokesman for the provincial forensic department, said possibly as many as 150 people were buried by family members after the earthquake in remote villages who had not been counted in the official death toll, the semi-official ISNA news agency reported. Iran's Red Crescent also said it worried about more bodies in rural villages, though it said the rescue operations in larger towns could end soon. President Hassan Rouhani arrived in Kermanshah province on Tuesday to see the damage for himself and offer his support to those affected. "This was a pain for all Iranians," Rouhani said, according to a statement on the presidency's website. "Representing the nation of Iran, I offer my condolences to the people of Kermanshah and tell them that all of us are behind Kermanshah." Iran's Foreign Minister Mohammad Javad Zarif offered his thanks to foreign countries, offering to help but wrote on Twitter, "For now, we are able to manage with our own resources." Cleric Abdal Hussein Moazi, a representative of Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei who also is touring the area, said there was a need for more relief material and security. That was echoed by Nazar Biranat, the mayor of the town of Ezhila, who told State TV on Tuesday his constituency still had a deep need for food, medicine and tents. He said 80% of the buildings in the town had been damaged by the quake. Many of the heavily damaged complexes in Sarpol Zahab were part of construction projects under former hardline President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad. The newly homeless slept outside in cold, huddled around makeshift fires for warmth. The quake killed 430 people in Iran and injured 7,460, state media reported Tuesday. Most of the injuries were minor, with fewer than 1,000 still hospitalized, Iran's Crisis Management Headquarters spokesman Behnam Sweedy told State TV. The official death toll came from provincial forensic authorities based on death certificates issued. Some reports said unauthorized burials without certification could mean the death toll was actually higher. The quake was centered about 19 miles 31 kilometers outside the eastern Iraqi city of Halabja, according to the U.S. Geological Survey, and struck 14.4 miles 23.2 kilometers below the surface, a somewhat shallow depth that can cause broader damage. The quake caused Dubai skyscrapers to sway and could be felt 1,060 kilometers 660 miles away on the Mediterranean coast. 7 deaths occurred in Iraq and 535 people were injured, all in the country's northern, semi-autonomous Kurdish region, according to its interior ministry. The disparity in casualty tolls immediately drew questions from Iranians, especially because so much of the town was new. Sarpol Zahab fell to the troops of Iraqi dictator Saddam Hussein during his 1980 invasion of Iran, which sparked the 8-year war between the two countries that killed 1 million people. Though clawed back by Iran 7 months later, the area remained a war zone that suffered through Saddam's missile attacks and chemical weapons. After the war, Iran began rebuilding the town. It also was part of Ahmadinejad's low-income housing project, which aided the Holocaust-questioning hardliners' populist credentials but also saw cheap construction. Under the plan dubbed as Mera Kindness in Farsi, some 2 million units were built in Iran, including hundreds in Sarpol Zahab. Many criticized the plan, warning that the low-quality construction could lead to a disaster. Before its 10-year anniversary, Mera buildings have turned into coffins for its inhabitants, the reformist Faroo News website wrote Monday. Rouhani himself said the government would launch an investigation into why the state constructed buildings so easily toppled. The faults and shortcomings in the construction of these buildings should be investigated, he said, according to the state-run IRNA news agency. The government will definitely follow up on these issues and identify the culprits. Iran sits on many major fault lines and is prone to near-daily quakes. In 2003, a magnitude 6.6 earthquake flattened the historic city of Bam, killing 26,000 people. In 2012, a major casualty earthquake killed over 300. Karimi reported from Tehran, Iran. Associated Press writer John Gambrill in Dubai, United Arab Emirates, contributed to this report. Copyright 2017, The Associated Press. All rights reserved. This material may not be published, broadcast, rewritten, or redistributed.